Hello students, today we are going to study a new chapter number 4 as per your syllabus, chapter number 4 which is short circuit studies, alright, short circuit studies using bus impedance matrix. Okay, so or you can say short circuit studies using Z bus matrix. Okay, so let's have some general introduction and idea about the power system analysis. Okay, so here we need to study the power system analysis and operation and control. So in this subject we will study the load flow problem, which we have already studied. Load flow, problem on load flow problem and fault analysis. Fault analysis. The second one is optimal load flow scheduling, optimal load scheduling, and the third one is system control problem. So for power flow, for power system analysis and control, or we can say our whole subject power system analysis and control is divided in these two three parts, or we can say overall power system engineering, not actually overall, but yeah, power system analysis and control is divided in these three major part. So from these we have studied the load flow problem. Then in this chapter we are going to study about the fault analysis. Later on we will study optimal load scheduling and a system control, or we can say power system stability. So for short circuit studies, again let me remind you one basic definition. What do you mean by power system? What is your basic understanding, the meaning of power system? So the power system is a system or arrangement where the generation, transmission and distribution of an electricity is take place and distributed to the end users, or we can say consumers, with the condition of economical, reliable and efficient. Economical, reliable and efficient condition, the consumer get the power supply. So such a system or arrangement we can say which is known as power system. Clear? Okay, so next is back to the track, that means to the chapter name short circuit studies, or we can say bus impedance matrix or Z bus matrix. So you all are studied graph theory in our chapter number 1. Yes, graph theory. Of course I will repeat again, but yes, the graph theory for calculation of ग्राफ थियरी और फॉर्मुलेशन ऑफ Weber's matrix. Okay, and even you have studied the two basic methods for formulation of Weber's matrix, a direct method or we can say non-singular method, direct or non-singular and singular transformation method. Singular transformation method. So, in this technique, for formulation of Weber's matrix, or we can say for formulation of network matrix. For formulation of network matrix using graph theory, we have studied two methods. The first one is non-singular and second one is singular method. In non-singular or direct method, we have just directly write down the equation whatever the network is given to us, and from that we will derive the bus admittance matrix. And in singular method, again we will apply the graph theory concept, and from then we will construct the system matrix A, and finally we will get the Weber's matrix using equation Weber's is equal to A transpose Y into A. So using this equation we will derive the network matrix, or we can say bus admittance matrix. Okay, so same way there are some disadvantages, because there are some disadvantages of such methods to derive the network matrix, or we can say the disadvantages of the direct or non-singular method for deriving the network matrix is, the biggest disadvantage is, or we can say main drawback is, for the network having large number of buses, and as we know, our power system is interconnected power system. Okay, and all the entire network having n number of buses in our system. So if we consider our entire nation, then there are n number of buses in our system. So for large number of buses and branches, this method will, that means these two methods will take more time for calculating. These methods will take more time. Just large number of buses, highlight this, large number of buses will take more time to formulate network matrix. You can say Weber's or Z-bus matrix. So to overcome this method, or to overcome this disadvantage, we are using the step-by-step method, or we can say building algorithm method. Method for determining or calculating or formulating Z-bus matrix. Okay, so this is the one drawback. This is the reason why we use the step-by-step method or building algorithm method, because of the large number of buses in our network, and using such methods, you can say direct method or singular and non-singular method, that time consumption is more. So We will use the step-by-step method and building algorithm method for formulating the ZBus. Of course, there are one more advantage, or we can say one more advantage to study this method. We will discuss later on what is that advantage, and because of this advantage, we will use the step-by-step method or building algorithm method for formulating a ZBus matrix. I hope you are clear up to this. Now, the next is, till now you have studied the fault analysis. Yes, till now you all are studying the fault analysis, or we can say studied for a symmetrical and unsymmetrical fault analysis. Fault analysis. So for that you are using, for such kind of fault analysis, you have used the network reduction technique. Yes, network reduction technique. So, using network reduction technique, you all are calculated the examples or the derived the theories for symmetrical and unsymmetrical fault analysis. So, in that you have calculated the or formulated the examples up to the network, or I can say you have solved the network up to the 2 or 2 to 5 bus network, or in some case up to 6 or 7, but more than that, not a single example you have solved where in your network you have calculated the example with a 10 number of buses, 15 number of buses, or I can say 100 number of buses. So ultimately I want to say that for fault analysis, or we can say symmetrical and unsymmetrical fault analysis, for the system where the n number of buses are there, for such type of fault analysis, you just need to require some computational process, or we can say some digital technique, or we can say computer calculation technique, or n bus type of system fault analysis, you require some computational technique, or I can say computer calculation technique, or digital calculation technique. So for such systematic process, you require some extraordinary method. You cannot directly apply this. Yes, of course you can apply this a network reduction technique, but using this network reduction technique, you can solve up to this for a small system, or I can say for 4 to 5 bus network you can calculate. For the n number of, or for large network, you need some systematic process to calculate a fault analysis of our network. So for that we need to study this step-by-step method, and this is the a building algorithm method which is used for formulating the ZBus matrix, and this ZBus will use for fault analysis. Okay, for n number of buses in your system. Okay, you all have studied the different types of fault, means is in unsymmetrical, which is a line to ground, double line to ground, triple line to ground fault, and for all this type you have calculated the example using this network reduction technique, but it is not feasible for the n number of system. So for that you need some systematic process to calculate the fault analysis, and for that we need to study this ZBus matrix. Okay, so before starting this, let me tell you one more thing. Yes, for power system studies, we require two types of buses, or we need to know about the two types of buses. The first one is YBus matrix and the second one is ZBus matrix. Either any one of these we can say we can perform the power system studies. Either any one of these bus, using this bus we can perform the power system studies. So as we have already studied that for YBus matrix, or using this YBus matrix, we can perform a power flow analysis, or we can say load flow analysis. So using YBus matrix we have done the power flow analysis, and using this ZBus matrix we will do, or we can perform the short circuit studies, or I can say fault analysis. So for fault analysis, or we can say short circuit studies, we need to study about the formulation of ZBus matrix. As we have already studied that for power flow analysis YBus matrix, similarly or same way we have to study the ZBus matrix for fault analysis matrix. Let me again tell you why we need to study the ZBus matrix or formulation of ZBus matrix, because fault analysis. Why? Because in previously you have studied or calculated the fault analysis, which is only limited for or using network reduction techniques. So using that or this method is limited up for the small network. So you can calculate or formulate for the n number of buses system, you just require some systematic approach. Systematic procedure to solve the fault analysis, and for that we will study the step by step method. Okay, so yes, I hope you are clear up to this. We will study, or we are going to study the power system analysis using these two buses. For power system studies, we need to study about these two buses. The bus number one, or we can say YBus, which we have already studied for power flow analysis, and ZBus, which we are going to study for short circuit studies, or we can say for fault analysis. Why? Because using network reduction technique, we can not solve or perform for the n number of buses fault analysis. So for that we need to study the formulation of ZBus matrix. So I ask one more thing. As compared to load flow studies, as we have already studied, as compared to power flow analysis, the short circuit studies is very easy. Short circuit study is easy, or fault analysis is easy. Why? Because in power flow analysis, the computational procedure, or we can say the direct solution, is not possible. So we use the iterative methods to solve the power flow analysis. Whereas In fault analysis, or I can say short circuit studies, the direct solution is possible. Direct solution is possible. So I can say that for short circuit study with the comparison of power flow analysis, the short circuit studies is very easy because the direct solution is possible. One more thing I want to say over here, if yes, we know the relation between Y and Z. So as we have already studied the formulation of fibers matrix, so for that, or we can say from that, we can directly derive the Z bus matrix using the relation is Y is equal to 1 by Z, or Z is equal to 1 upon Y. But numerically it is not economical to obtain the Z bus directly from the Y bus, because as we all already said, for the n number of buses we cannot directly inverse. Of course we can, but it is not feasible solution to just take the inverse of Y bus matrix to obtain the Z bus, because for n number of buses system, just assume for the 1000 bus network the size of Y bus matrix is 1000 × 1000, and to take the inverse of this 1000 × 1000, it is not mathematically economic to take the inverse of such kind of matrix. So it is advisable over here that we need to calculate or formulate the Z bus matrix using this step-by-step method or any systematical procedure for formulating the Z bus matrix. So I hope you have clear the importance of Z bus matrix, comparison between the Y bus and Z bus matrix, and the why we need to use the bus impedance matrix for short circuit studies. Clear? Now the next is concept of graph theory. I know we have already studied, but I will remind you again the concept of graph theory, because to formulate the Z bus matrix using singular transformation we have to study about the network theory, which we have already studied for formulating the Y bus matrix using singular transformation. So same way we need to study about graph theory for the formulation of Z bus matrix. So let us understand again some basic terminologies in graph theory. Graph theory. So we'll explain you some basic definition of the graph theory. The first one is elements and node, and node. To understand all the definition, just consider this network, a simple just 4 bus network. Okay, here is the connection 1, 2, 3, and 4, 4 bus network. To understand the concept of graph theory, the first one is elements and node. So to describe the geographical, to describe say figure number 1, to describe this figure number 1, or I can say geographical features of the network, this network is replaced by single line. That means, to describe the geometrical features of of any power system network, it is replaced by single line. Is replaced by single line, and that single line which is known as elements. That single line which is known as elements, and the terminal of terminals of the elements which is known as nodes. Here first definition, elements and node again. So let me just draw this figure number 1 with a single line representation. Here 1, 2, bus number 3 and bus number 4. So this is the simple connection for bus number 1, 2, 3 and 4, and which is replaced by the single line. So this single line is known as elements of the network, and the terminal of these elements which is known as nodes. Clear? Elements and nodes. And the next second definition, I can say graph. So the resulting figure, let's say figure number 2, the resultant figure which is known as graph, resultant figure of this single line network which is known as graph, which consists of elements and node, which is known as graph. Clear? So figure number 2 is known as graph. And if we assign the direction to the graph, then it is known as oriented graph. Clear? Next is tree and co-tree. Yes, this is the most required understanding for the formulation of ZBUS matrix. Okay, you must clear about the trees, branches, co-trees and links. Okay, so let us understand tree. So a connected subgraph. Okay, I'll write a connected subgraph containing all the nodes of graph, containing all the node of graph, but having no closed path which is known as tree. Clear? Which is known as tree. So for the tree again, a connected subgraph containing all the nodes of graph. So from graph you can draw the tree or derive the tree. with the condition of no closed path formed by that subgraph. So I will draw here. Just let me introduce one line here. That's why we can understand. Yes. Yeah. Here. So let's draw the tree. So the condition for the tree is all nodes are considered, and there should not be a closed path formed by that subgraph, which is known as your tree. So there are many possibilities of tree. You can draw any type of tree, but the condition will remain same, that there should not be a closed path is formed. So this is your tree. Write number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Here also, I just forgot to numbering. Yes, for numbering, you just need to remember that for numbering and direction, we will consider a clockwise direction. Yes. And for numbering, we will start from least number. Yes. A smaller number. Start from a small number. Okay. So here, this element number, here total 1, 2, 3 and 4 elements are there, as there are 4 transmission line in our network. So the first number will start from least number, that means from number 1. So from number 1 to 2 and priority base. Yes. So from 1 to 2, which is first element E1, 1 to 3, it is E2. Now after completion of node 1, or we can say least number 1, we will move towards the second number. And from node 2 to 3, it is 2 to 4, it is elements 3, and the last 2 to 3, it is element 3, and the last one is element 4. Clear? Similarly, next, the elements of tree, which is shown in figure number 3. The elements of tree is known as branches. The elements of tree is known as branches. Clear? Branches. So again I will assign the direction and write the number. So I will say the elements between bus number 1 and 2, which is B1, branch number 1, 1 and 3, B2, and here it is B3. Clear? I hope you are clear up to this. Now, the next one is co-tree. Co-tree. So, those elements of graph are not included in tree. Those elements of graph, or we can say in figure number 2, are not included in figure number 3, or we can say in to the tree. Those elements of graph which is not included, a remaining portion of graph, let me write, a remaining portion of graph which is not included into the tree is known as co-tree. See, for this example, the remaining portion is only the element E3. So, for this, here, I can say generally it is represented as dotted line. So this figure number 4 is co-tree for this system, co-tree between bus number is 3 and 2, or 2 and 3. Clear the direction, and here is a numbering L1. Why? Because the elements of co-tree are known as links. So I hope you have cleared about the graph, oriented graph, tree, branches, co-tree, and elements of co-tree, which is links. Clear? So this is most important part of this chapter. You must very well know about this graph theory portion, or I can say for tree, graph, branches, co-tree, and link. Because the for formulation of ZBus matrix, you must know about these all parameters. I hope you have cleared up to this. Okay.